everyone. My name is Landy Oshinowo, and I play Mrs. Phelps the Librarian in the Royal Shakespeare Company's production of Matilda the Musical in the West End. Now we're going to meet a very special little girl called Matilda. Matilda loves to read, but she lives with her horrid parents who hate everything about books and learning. When Matilda meets her awful headmistress, Miss Trunchbull, she realizes that she can use a most extraordinary power to set things right. In this part of the story, Matilda's about to use her power for the first time to teach the terrifying Trunchbull a lesson. Matilda felt herself getting angrier and angrier and angrier. So unbearably angry that something was bound to explode inside her very soon. The newt was still squirming in the tall glass of water. It looked horribly uncomfortable. The glass was not big enough for it. Matilda glared at the Trunchbull. How she hated her. She glared at the glass with the newt in it. She longed to march up and grab the glass and tip the contents, newt and all, over the Trunchbull's head. She trembled to think what the Trunchbull would do to her if she did that. The Trunchbull was sitting behind the teacher's table, staring with a mixture of horror and fascination at the newt wriggling in the glass. Matilda's eyes were riveted to the glass. And now, quite slowly, there began to creep over Matilda a most extraordinary and peculiar feeling. The feeling was mostly in the eyes. A kind of electricity seemed to be gathering inside them. A sense of power was brewing in those eyes of hers. A feeling of great strength was settling itself deep inside her eyes. But there was also another feeling, which was something else altogether, and which she could not understand. It was like flashes of lightning. Little waves of lightning seemed to be flashing out of her eyes. Her eyeballs were beginning to get hot, as though vast energy was building up somewhere inside them. It was an amazing sensation. She kept her eyes steadily on the glass, and now the power was concentrating itself in one small part of each eye and growing stronger and stronger. And it felt as though millions of tiny little invisible arms with hands on them were shooting out of her eyes towards the glass she was staring at. "Tip it," Matilda whispered. "Tip it over." She saw the glass wobble. It actually tilted backwards a fraction of an inch and then righted itself again. She kept pushing at it with all those millions of invisible little arms and hands that were reaching out from her eyes, feeling the power that was flashing straight from the two little black dots in the very center of her eyeballs. "Tip it," she whispered again. "Tip it over." Once more, the glass wobbled. She pushed harder still, willing her eyes to shoot out more power. And then very, very slowly, so slowly she could hardly see it happening, the glass began to lean backwards, further and further and further backwards until it was balancing on just one edge of its base. And there it teetered for a few seconds before it finally toppled over and falling with a sharp tinkle on the desktop. The water in it and the squirming newt splashed all over Miss Trunchbull's enormous bosom. The headmistress let out a yell that must have rattled every window pane in the building. And for the second time in the last 5 minutes, she shot out of her chair like a rocket. Well, Matilda really taught the Trunchbull a lesson, didn't she?